thing first, perk popper. Drink always muddy, flooded. Crush ice in the cup, it look diamond studded. Slushy, fucking codeine raw, but I ain't bustin'. Throw her in a drink, she throw me in park, and I ain't budgin'. Ooh, something say the lean makes the drink seem spectacular. Wakisha ain't no activist, but she could act like her. Shiverin', I'm leaning, pivoting. Chill, relax, fine. Let me pull up a line. Ring, ring around a rosy. Leaning, got me dozing. Two cups, keep her cozy. Fire, I'm blowing like King Koopa Yoshi. Murder, she rolled me with a purple emoji. Yeah, the days are just colder without her, without my soda Osama. When it comes to that wild girl, I got that whole better flagger. Keisha,
1 minute, I'm done.
Welcome back. B-A-C-K, biggity, 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 biggity. Biggity, 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 back. Welcome to another episode of Extraordinary Gentlemen Podcast. I am your host, episode 33. I got my brother Z with me, and we have our, I guess you can say what, our first lady? First guest. Now she back to talk about these topics with us. The one and only Miss Towels, Janay.
Miss Price.
Miss Price.
Period.
Check your status.
Oh, you ain't doing no hyphenation. Z say, oh no, you take that hype off, huh?
I gotta take that off, man. It's all or nothing with me, baby.
It's all or nothing with me. Don't start.
How we doing?
Cool, man.
Good?
Yeah.
How was the week?
Busy.
Yeah, I bet it was. I bet it was.
Busy. Ain't no more sitting on your ass no more, Jack.
That shit feel good, though. I bet you, though, bro. You could move at your own, the toot of your own horn.
It is, but it's like, it's not really like that yet. So it's like, man, I'm more just
waiting.
Not waiting, but just like antsy. Like,
oh, okay.
Let's do it.
Yeah.
Let's do it.
What about you, Janay? How was your week?
I had a long week. It's the end of our 6 weeks. So,
grades,
students want to know, like, how am I feeling? Like, you ain't did nothing all, like, the first 6 weeks. I don't know why you surprised. so, just dealing with that, dealing with some parents, you know. It was a long week. I'm glad I was off on Friday. Well, I'm glad it was no students on Friday.
That's crazy. Like, Essential was like that, too.
Yeah, it was. Well, we had professional development, so we had to do, like, those teacher trainings.
Oh.
And then that just gave me time to get my classroom in order, too, because we don't have custodians right now.
They ain't got no custodians.
Mm-mm. They just built a new elementary school, so they have them, like, all at the elementary school. So we're responsible for, like, sweeping and
mopping. Who took out the trash?
Me and my students. Students love me, so they'll, like, if they see it full, they'll be like, Miss T, you want me to take it out? I'm like, yeah, that's cool. Because normally I just do it at the end of the day.
Yeah, nah, you know me, baby. You got to throw some extra credit for that.
I'm going to give him 5 points.
Nigga,
10 points.
Fucking trash for free.
You know, with Stavion playing in the middle of the week, I leave that classroom how it is. Baby, yeah. I got to make it on time.
Yeah.
So I spent my Friday, like, just doing a deep cleaning at work. Yeah. So it was cool.
Yeah, my week, had a chance to get almost 150 points. We had to wire this schematic for 100. The preacher was like, if y'all can get this in under 15 minutes, I'm going to give y'all 150 points extra credit.
What's that? What you say, wire?
Wire schematic. So they give us this electrical panel, and we have to wire it, cut it, make sure all the terminals are connected properly, and we power it up and make sure that the electricity is going. We didn't get that shit. No, it was a hard schematic. It was a 3-page schematic, and he wanted us to do it in 15 minutes.
Did y'all finish it though?
We did finish it. It took 2 hours.
Damn. That nigga say 15 minutes.
Took 2 hours.
Damn, he give y'all any points for
that? No.
Oh, that nigga low down.
Yeah, but he knew what he was doing because he knew it. Once you get good at it, it only takes 15 minutes.
Oh, so he was trying to
see where we was at.
Yeah,
but
y'all niggas.
Did anybody get it or no?
From what we heard, like with my class, it's only HEB people, and then on another day, it's the Toyota people by themselves. And from what we were told, we did better than the Toyota people. Oh. The Toyota people didn't even finish it.
Wow. Niggas say, fuck this.
When we seen that schematic, he's like, oh yeah, we got this. Because we train every Friday on wire and shit. Nah, bro, we gave him some shit we never seen before, bro.
Damn.
That shit was scary. I was like, this is what it's like out there?
How many of y'all is it?
It's only five of us. Five. And then we have one dude from Toyota Tattoo. So basically that's like, they do the certain parts for Toyota. Mm. Like tires, anything with plastic and rubber, they do that type of stuff. Mm.
Man, niggas say, y'all got 15 men. Niggas say, it took us 2 hours.
Yeah, we wanted that 150 points, but I knew it was a catch to it.
That nigga low down, he could have gave y'all something.
Yeah.
Especially knowing that y'all beat the other guys.
Yeah. It's like, hell no.
Count.
Yeah, that's true.
that's true.
Let's see. Where y'all want to start? You want to start? First off, let's do a start with AJ Johnson.
Ezell.
R.I.P. AJ Johnson, a.k.a. Ezell, a.k.a. Lil Man. Most people don't know about that.
What was he Lil Man on?
Players Club.
Players Club, yeah.
Oh, that was the name. That Lil was my Man. Favorite.
Because I seen a thing. He was only in, what, three movies?
I think it was like four.
Only four movies? Four.
Yeah.
It's like, damn.
You would expect him to be in more, yeah. Right? Yeah. Yeah, that was shocking, though.
I see Michael Blackson gave him like $20,000 for the funeral.
Oh, for real?
Yeah.
Yeah, I read he didn't have life insurance.
Shit. Well, I mean, well, shit, he wasn't working. I seen an interview with him a while back on Vlad. Ice Cube kind of blackballed him.
Oh, man. How?
He asked for more money for Friday.
Is that why he wasn't in the rest of
them? Well, he showed up. He didn't know they were shooting. He showed up. Somebody told him they were shooting the
next Friday.
So he showed up to the scene, and they had him removed.
No shit.
Yeah.
Oh, that's fucked up.
Well, you know, I hate getting messy, but on Twitter, Ice Cube wrote a little thing or whatever, and some reporter put, "How dare you write this, knowing what you did all these years? You lowballed him on money." And you wouldn't let him be in another movie or something like that.
That is crazy.
But now that you're saying that, that makes sense.
He said it on the interview. He that came out of his mouth.
Damn,
that's crazy.
And when I seen he was only in four movies, I'm like, man, them were old. Them shit. Oh. Them was before the 2000s.
Them were his peak movies.
Because when the next Friday come out?
We
I know Friday
out
came out in the 90s for sure.
Next Friday was probably like the 2000s. We were probably still in school, so like the 2000s.
Damn.
So, and then Players Club was in the 90s. I Got the Hookup was in the 90s.
I Got the Hookup, yup.
So he really... But Ice Cube was in Players Club. But that wasn't his movie though, right?
That was probably shit. It was probably around the same time though.
I wonder if that was his movie.
Nah, that wasn't his. That was a... what's the director name?
Oh, I forgot about I Got the Hookup.
That's one of my favorites. That was like probably one of my favorite movies that he played in.
He was in Menace to Society?
I don't remember him in Menace. I don't remember what his role would have been.
I don't remember him in none of these. I know he was in House Parties. That's why.
Oh,
I
was you know what? They might be getting confused with the other AJ Johnson.
Oh, the lady.
The lady.
Oh, okay.
From Billy. I mean, Baby Boy.
They done got it confused already.
Because I'm like, I don't remember him being in Menace to Society.
Shit, I don't remember her being in Menace
to Society. What would y'all say y'all favorite movie of him was, though?
Friday.
I Got the Hookup.
Nah. Oh, of him?
Give me two pumps and a garage.
We don't get talking like that.
He said, I'll throw a bullet at you. Remember when he was in the car? He was like, you loyal girl, you loyal girl. How the fuck is you pointing the gun at me?
I say Friday.
I don't know, bro. His role in...
Ezell?
His role in Players Club was funny, too.
Oh, yeah, that one was really good.
His role in Players Club was funny. The nigga, they got the littlest nigga in there, the doorman.
Well, I say that'd be the funniest. Because he wasn't really funny in Friday. No, he was just a crackhead.
Yeah.
He was in there like this.
Yeah,
he was
really, So it probably was. That was probably his biggest role.
Babs? Oh, he was in Babs.
Oh, yeah. He was homegirl.
Boyfriend.
Nieces, yeah.
He was in Babs.
I love you. I forgot
how to be a player, too.
Oh, so maybe they meant he only had four leading roles.
Maybe that's, but was he a leading? But I mean, I
got the hookup. He was,
yeah. I don't know what we consider a lead. Oh, he was in Hot Boys and Foolish too.
Oh, I don't even remember those.
Great White Hype. I remember that one.
Our niggas did more than four movies then.
Yeah. But yeah, RIP, man. Yeah, I forgot about Repos too. But that kind of goes back to what we talked about on the earlier episode. What we were talking about, make sure you get your life insurance, your shit in order, man. Like, shouldn't no, I hate to say it like this, but shouldn't no one of his caliber be doing no, you know, GoFundMes or something like that for a funeral?
I mean, but look at the last time he worked, man. The last movie came out and shit.
What?
He ain't worked in damn 10, 15 years.
Yeah. I wonder how much of their royalties from Friday, though, bro.
They, shit.
From what, I seen something where Chris Tucker said that they only get, like, maybe $100 for royalties
probably,
for Friday.
It's probably not even they get some change. Shit, he only got, what, $1,100, $1,200 for the role?
Yeah. That's why Chris Tucker, and I hate to say it, like, that's why he said he'll never do another one.
Yeah, they had that money right.
Because they felt like after it became successful, they should have went back to the drawing table. And
nobody really benefited off of that, yep. But Ice Cube.
Yep. Ooh, that's bad
because
look.
Really, Chris Tucker made that movie.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
And he should have got the most money.
Yeah.
Even though, I mean, I'm pretty sure he got a nice piece of change for I Got the Hookup. Because I'm pretty sure P wouldn't do him like that.
Yeah. P was giving everybody money.
But yeah, man.
That's sad.
I'm watching that tonight.
How did he pass away? Did they say?
I don't know. I've seen it yet.
We can look though real quick.
On his interviews, he looked it a little bad.
What, sick?
Yeah. I didn't want to say sick, but yeah, he looked
what
bad.
Like
he talked
chronic
he talked,
illness or just
he talked different. It was just like he wasn't all the way there.
Oh, okay, I see what you're saying. Let's see, AJ Johnson.
He was Bill Bellamy's friend. I was trying to figure out what role did he play in How to Be a Player.
Only 55.
That's super young, bro. Come on.
And Friday is the only movie that they mentioned.
That's the only movie, which is crazy because he was in plenty of other roles.
They didn't have to put that picture.
Smokey, you were eating corn, huh? Saying about the loss of an amazing, iconic legend in comedy.
Still haven't been released.
Because I know when, the other day, when they had posted, it still hadn't had what the cause was.
Oh.
Yeah. I'm pretty sure it'll be out this week. Mm-hmm.
What's crazy, I had that shirt.
For real?
I bought that. My uncle bought me that shirt when we was in, what you call that beach in L.A.?
Venice
Beach. I got that shirt. That is my favorite shirt. That was live.
Yeah, that's. But they also just released the cause of Michael K. Williams' death too, though.
Well, we all knew that though.
Yeah,
already knew that shit.
But why are they saying overdose on fentanyl when? Whoever they bond these, like, this is what, the third or fourth person that they say from an overdose of fentanyl?
So are they, like, because I asked DeAndre, are they, like, shooting it?
I don't know.
Like, what is the intake?
I don't know. I'm guessing it's pills, right?
Okay. That's why I didn't know. It has to be pills. Is it pills? Or are they, like, what? How is, because he's, like, the third person, right?
Yeah. It was Juice WRLD. Michael K.
Well, Juice WRLD took the it was so if that if it was the same thing as Juice WRLD, he took the pills.
Mm-hmm.
He swallowed the motherfuckers.
Yeah. I just wish they would stop saying that it's an overdose. But because obviously whoever they buying from is putting more of a specific.
Oh, he might have took too many.
Yeah, but they.
But if he been popping pills, he know how many he could pop.
Exactly. He just bought us some.
It
was stronger.
Bad bag.
Yeah, might have been one of them wild nights.
Oh my god!
She get out of hand.
New music, which I've been listening to. I know we got Nay on, so I know she been listening to some.
Actually, I So when I started sending notes, I was like, hopefully they don't ask me about this topic. Because I have really embraced being in my 30s. I literally listen to R&B, but old R&B. And then when I listen to y'all, I'll go download some stuff. And I'll get on TikTok, like, for new music.
Somebody told me that's the new spot for music. One of the younger dudes in my cohort, he said, "Man, I go to TikTok for when I want to hear a song that's popping."
Yeah,
that's crazy. We was at my niece's party last night, and they was telling my brother-in-law Darren to go on TikTok, get the new music. Nigga, what the fuck are you playing?
TikTok is like
that. Nigga downloaded the TikTok app right then and now. They told me, I ain't gonna lie, the shit he started playing
was updated.
I said, "Hey, where this shit come from?" Like, it's a song with Coi Leray.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah,
she got some shit on TikTok.
She's
about,
singing a little.
Yeah,
bit?
Yeah. Oh, I said that shit hard.
Yeah,
bro,
that shit hard.
So when I get bored, I go to TikTok and then I just start downloading. But I can't really tick, you know.
Nah,
but I'm still listening to. This is so embarrassing. I'm still listening to the Lil Baby and Lil Durk.
Oh, that album was good, though.
Rotation.
But I know, goddamn, this past week, bro, they've been dropping music like, it seemed like everybody's waiting on Drake to drop. So now they could
get that out the way.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. We're going to start dropping our music now.
I was on that little top, that young boy.
I heard some of the songs, bro, and he's starting to grow on me, bro.
You liking him?
I'm starting to like him a lot. I was telling Darius the other day, like, he was the one that used to try to get me to listen to him. I'm like, man, I can't listen to that.
Don't listen to that.
See, I never know what song I like until I hear Zalia playing it over and over. I'm like, oh, that's the one. Because she the biggest young boy fan. So when I hear Zalia playing that shit over and over, I'm like, oh, yeah, that's the one.
But yeah, his new album was Sincerely Cantrell. I listened to a little bit of the songs on there. It sounded pretty good.
Went number one on Apple.
Yes, he did. Passed Drake up.
That nigga went number one before the shit even came out.
Yeah.
His baby mamas was talking cash shit.
For real?
Mm-hmm. They was just like, number one, ain't did no promo.
And no big artists was reposting it.
And did y'all see what YouTube was saying that they won't post this show? Because of his image.
Image.
Oh.
I seen what's his name? Batman Kevo, whatever his name is. He was like, "That's fucked up. YouTube made all that money off of him. Now he can't do nothing for him because he's in jail, mm-hmm. and now they don't want to fuck with him."
Because he was like the highest paid. Well, he wasn't a YouTuber, but he was making a lot of money from YouTube.
From what I just read this morning, he's still the highest. Well, the most streams? Yeah, something like that.
Ain't nobody fuck on YoungBoy.
What else came out? G-Eazy. I haven't listened to that album yet.
Oh, I like that Bia and Herbo.
Oh, yeah.
I listened to it last night. I watched the video. I got to play it a few times, but I think I'm
going to grow on it.
Yeah.
This album, this D-Smoke. Y'all remember D-Smoke from the Netflix with Cardi B, Chance, and T.I.?
Oh, I never watched that.
Oh, they had that show, but I ain't watch it.
Yeah. Well, his brother is Sir. Y'all know Sir with TDE, the singer?
Nah, Benny.
I'm sorry.
Where the crickets at?
Benny.
Nah, but he got a song on here that's real tight with his brother, Sir. That song is tight, but also it's a song with Ty Dolla $ign. Right here, this one. This mug is that mug jam, bro.
I like Ty Dolla $ign. We still looking for that guitar, nigga. You always a guitar in San Antonio.
What else? Like I say, bro, I looked on here. It was a whole bunch of shit dropping, bro.
What's the nigga name, man? Tory Lanez.
What? He dropped something? Yeah, a mixtape?
I heard a few songs off of it, Benny. I think I like it. I like him.
It's your first time listening to him?
Nah, I just stopped.
Oh, because
I jumped on. I was one of them niggas.
Yeah.
He shot the brawl, man.
Yeah, yeah.
He got like an 80s theme shit.
I seen he was coming out with a mixtape, but I thought it was only NFT. Mm. Well, he was doing that NFT shit, trying to make money off of it. It's banging. Well, his last, I hate to say it, but his last album was good, though. The cover with Ashanti on there.
Oh yeah.
That album was good, but everybody quit playing it once all that.
Once all the shit happened.
Yeah.
But I see a lot of people starting to post pictures and shit of them, and He working his way back in.
But from his little tweets and shit, he making it seem like he finna walk away from this shit.
I still want to know what the fuck happened.
I seen that he's supposed to be taking like a plea deal.
Oh, so he is gonna take a plea deal?
I had seen on one of those.
It's probably some slap on the wrist type shit.
Mm-hmm. What else we got? Anthony Hamilton dropped a new.
Oh, I like him.
I haven't listened to it, but the majority of this album is produced by JD.
Oh, shit.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
What is that called? Love is in the Black.
What else? Alana Baez. She got a couple nice tracks on there that I like. But Damani.
What's her name? T.I. son?
Yes.
He jamming?
Yes.
Oh, I forgot he's a rapper.
Yeah. But they got him. I don't know why, though. They got him with the R&B soul. His genre is an R&B soul. But this, to me, it didn't sound. I mean, guess you could say it's R&B soul because it's like a laid-back type rap.
So do he sound like T.I.?
Nah.
He
totally did. I heard one of his songs. I ain't heard the new album, but I heard one of his songs a while back. He totally different from T.I.
But it was somebody else I wanted to let to put people on that I had just freaking heard about. And I was, you know, going down a rabbit hole listening to music. I don't even know if I can freaking find it. Oh, there you go, right there. Wait. Let me see if I can find it. Where the heck it go? But what else you been listening to, Nay? I know you, besides Lil Durk and Lil Baby.
Shit. Drake and...
So now that we all sat on the Drake, it's been out, what, about 3 weeks now?
Mm-hmm. At first, I was not feeling it. I was like, And even Amber texts me like, yo, it dropped. And I'm like, girl, I was not feeling that. When we ended up going to Vegas and we were talking about, I was like, I wasn't feeling it. Maybe I need to play it again. But I've been playing it too, and so now I like it. I think I wanted him to be, I haven't had a singing Drake.
Oh, so you want that Take Care Drake.
Yeah, so that's what I was more in tune for. But after I played it back, this is Talking Shit Drake, and that's kind of what I'm on. So I like it a lot now. But at first, I was like, this is not what I was looking for.
Sound like you ain't fucking with it no more, Benny.
I'm not.
You're not fucking with it.
Not no more. What? Only song I really go back to is the Champagne Poetry.
Oh, that's my favorite.
And then Pipe Down.
Daddy's Home. I like it, Benny.
I like Daddy's Home, too.
I know you like Daddy Home. Oh, baby. Oh, I know you like Daddy Home.
You gotta get your motherfucking mama.
So damn, Benny.
But they working that Way Too Sexy album song like a mug, and I don't like that.
That was probably my least.
I like the video too.
That's probably why with Kawhi,
goofy ass.
He talk about.
But you see, he go. Norris said he gonna be on Drake Champs this week.
I seen that this morning.
Kawhi?
No.
Nigga Drake.
Oh,
Drake.
I was like, wait, what?
Yeah, they saying Drake gonna be on there, but he been pushing for Drake for a minute though.
Well, like that should be good. I hope he on there popping his shit. Like I hope Nori don't interview like he interview Nas.
Oh.
I want you to get to the business.
How you
interview
Nas?
He didn't ask him the right questions. Oh.
Mm-hmm.
He asked.
Well, you gotta know your limits.
Nah, fuck that. Because
if you want to get another
you
one,
come to Drink Champs.
Yeah, for if you want to get another interview,
you gotta warm up.
Know what Drink Champs is. Everybody knows what Drink Champs is. Don't come on here with no lollipop interview. I want to ask that nigga the questions. That's the reason you on here.
Z want that nigga to go in. Yeah.
Nah, I don't want him to go in, but okay, ask the questions. Drink Champs is the place you go. That Norby's gonna ask you the questions that everybody else is scared to ask.
So, what do you want him to ask?
I was just gonna say that.
Specifically,
like, I want him to get into the Pusha T shit. I want him to get into the motherfucking the Kanye West shit. I want him to get into did he really knock off Nicki Minaj? That's what Drink Champs is, baby.
You do not need to know if he knocks her down. What?
I just want to know.
No.
I just want to know. So ask that nigga the right questions.
Yeah, it should be interesting if he do. I wish he would do the Tiger Bone still. That must be banned.
They ain't cut the check.
So he quit doing it?
Yeah, the nigga get paid. Nigga, Jay-Z and them was giving him some money for that.
The Ace of Spades. P. Diddy giving him some money of
that. Even the shit that the other nigga drank.
Ross?
Nah, that EFN drink, some kind of marijuana. It's called marijuana. It's, oh. I think it's
a beer type stuff.
It's like beer. They get paid for that. It's what's the Pit Bull? I think it's Pit Bull shit.
You know EFN is in talks with them like that. Like he cool with them. So
they getting money, and you know that Tiger Bone shit was free. Nigga.
But you know what they should have, because that's when we went to New York. That's when everybody started. You and Jeremy was like, we have to buy this.
And we bought that shit.
That shit was disgusting.
Nasty as hell, boy.
That shit was
brought
nasty.
Us back a shot of that shit. It's crazy because me and QD was talking about that. Before y'all had got there.
The Tiger Bone?
We was just talking about that.
Did he try it?
He got some. We all tried that shit.
I tried it.
We tried it at
QD probably liked that shit.
I don't know. But
he said he ain't like it.
He said it had a weird taste.
It was nasty as a motherfucker, but shit, we can go move up.
What we got? Oh yeah, so the lady I was telling y'all about that y'all need to check out. I don't know how to pronounce her name, but her name is Marie Dahlstrom. Of course, I heard this on another podcast, and then the song, I was like, oh shit, this whole bang. But oh, I'm not gonna play. Yeah, I'm not gonna play a clip of it because that's too much editing.
Have you listened to Joss Stone?
No. Oh, okay. I never heard of that. Who is it?
She's a singer. She's from the UK. She's like, I listened to her for years. But I was going to ask, is she like the same vibe as her? Joss Stone is kind of like neo soul, kind of.
Yeah. I'm going to have to check that out.
See, this be the shit I be talking about, Benny. If like I seen her face on goddamn on the brows, I would never click on her name.
Like this song, bro. Like this song is tight, and I heard it on another podcast.
I would have never gave her a shot.
It ain't gonna play.
That's how I started listening to Joss Stone behind Tashe. I was like, oh, that's
it's crazy because once you start listening to different types of genre of music, and it just used to fall down a rabbit hole. Mm-hmm. Debbie Allen receives the Governor's Award. Did y'all see this?
Yeah, I saw that on the Jasmine Brand blog. Okay.
Little Debbie.
Look like Felicia, bro.
Does. They are so beautiful.
But yeah, congratulations to Debbie Allen. She becomes the first black woman to receive the Governor's Award at the Emmys, which was last week. She deserved flowers, bro, mainly for A Different World.
Yeah.
That shit was culture changing.
And it's this show on TV One, I think it's Uncensored. Her episode on
was
Uncensored,
good.
Yes, it was.
Okay, it
was
David.
Good.
It was really
good.
On you.
It was good.
I learned a lot about, like, it's crazy with how much stuff people do that just don't make it to the media because she gives back a lot.
She got her own. She got like a whole bunch of dancing studios.
Yeah,
I watched that Uncensored a lot. Yeah. I seen that the last episode I seen probably was with what's the mama name off of y'all remember?
The
Carmichael Show.
Oh, I haven't watched hers yet.
Loretta Devine.
I haven't watched hers yet. I thought you were talking about the mama from That's Always Yelling.
Who?
She was Terrence Howard's mom in that Steve Harvey movie.
Okay.
I can't think of her name, but I know you're talking about.
Yeah, she her Uncensored was real good too. But I haven't even started the new season. I need to.
Let's get to the juices. Speaking of Drake earlier, it was shit going on Twitter this week. They was comparing this man to Michael Jackson.
What's wrong with that?
Don't have me get up and walk off this set.
What's wrong with that?
Bro,
Drake,
you see this shit?
Does not have that kind of impact.
Bro, you see that shit, bro? That's not a concert, bro.
If somebody knew what Drake was going to be, it would be that.
Nah, bro.
Niggas move too secretive now. If somebody knew Drake was in that hotel, or if they knew where he was going to be, it would be that. Mayhem.
Nah, bro. You terrific,
ass. It would be mayhem.
You are tripping.
See, y'all don't like living in a present.
We're not saying that. I'm not saying he's a global icon. Yes, but as far as Michael Jackson status, bro.
First of all,
now see,
nobody could ever really be on Michael Jackson status. That's like a one of a kind. Mm-hmm. He has people passing out crying.
And that we thought nobody be on Michael Jordan status. And LeBron is up there. Y'all niggas gotta get with the time, man. The people ain't falling out crying when they say, oh, you know what? They all still do. I just seen a nigga crying when he seen the baby. So, you know what I'm saying? I was gonna say niggas ain't falling out crying when they see superstars no more, because we see them every day on social media.
Oh, that might be a little something. But you know what I'm saying?
But if Drake put the word out, hey, I'm gonna be here, it's gonna look like that.
Fool, you can't even see the street.
If Beyonce put out a word or something, it's gonna look like that.
I don't know.
Man, y'all.
I don't know.
Mike ain't the only nigga to do this shit.
I don't know, bro.
I'm telling you, Drake.
We are the world.
Anywhere Drake goes, gonna be a packed house just like that. Anywhere. I guarantee you, dog.
They not even out like that outside of a concert.
I was just gonna say, yeah, bro, that's not a concert, bro.
I know it's not a concert.
That's outside his room window. I'm saying you not Drake. Don't even get that outside of a concert.
Y'all go kill me for this.
Y'all
go kill me. We ain't been no Drake concert. We have. Drake concert with.
We have.
Every night we in the bed, I show you fucking Rod Wave concerts and look at that shit.
Right. But this, we're not talking about a concert. I'm just saying that. Outside.
Man. I'm telling you, Drake.
A concert going to be packed, but on the outside. A concert is going to be packed, bro. Like waiting.
I'll tell you.
Yeah, Drake. Cat, you looking at that wrong, man.
I'll tell you, Drake could do this, dog. I just think y'all just think y'all ain't going to see it again, but it's happening right now. In 20 years, I'm like, damn, Drake was that nigga.
No, we're not saying
that. He's definitely like a global star or whatever, but he not doing that.
What is he doing? It's just niggas showing up to see him.
Exactly.
Bro, at his hotel.
If somebody knew where Drake was staying, they would
people
show up.
People be knowing where Drake's staying.
Yeah, they do,
no, they
bro.
Don't. No, they
people
don't.
People be knowing.
No, they don't.
His fool couldn't even walk on Rodeo Drive.
Shit, I can't walk on Rodeo Drive, baby. I can't
walk on Rodeo
Drive. No, I'm saying, if somebody seen Drake on Rodeo Drive, you think they ain't swarming this nigga? They'll swarm Kim Kardashian goofy ass.
At this point, outside, Kim Kardashian has more of a crowd than Drake outside.
Ooh. You crazy.
She might be.
We can move on. I'm just saying. Drake is Mike Jack right now. So I don't think that's a bad comparison.
I don't think so, Kat.
I don't think it's a bad comparison.
Mike Jackson was a global icon, yeah. Bro.
What y'all think Drake is?
Drake is a global star. A global star, exactly.
He's not a global icon.
Y'all saying that because Mike dead now.
Bro, he was.
What the?
Bro.
Y'all saying that shit because Mike dead. You know when niggas die, man, their statue get higher.
No, his statue was high when he was alive. I just saw a thing where Eminem, I don't know how true it is, but I had just saw a thing where Eminem took a shot at Michael Jackson and Michael Jackson bought all his masters. So, like, nigga, I'm about to get paid.
Drake is doing the same shit. He just said it on the song. He got 20% of your shit.
Dude.
That's what I asked you on the podcast. Who's he talking about? Drake got 20% of some nigga shit. That's what I want Nori to ask him when he come on the podcast.
He's so damn
that be the shit I be talking about, man.
I be wanting to run a blog site, man. Yeah,
that be the shit I be talking about. We talking about Michael Jackson about Eminem shit. So Drake just did the same shit.
But he got it all. He ain't getting no 20. He ain't moving like Mike at the end of the day, baby.
Mike still get his ass whooped by his daddy. And he'll cry.
But this nigga going to a different level.
That's too far.
He went to a different
level. Like, that's too far, dog.
Mike, Joe still punch on Mike.
That's too far, man. He needs to chill. Don't do Mike.
But I'm saying, dog, that's not too far off a comparison, fool. I think Drake is up there.
We're not saying he's not up there.
We're just saying that
but
he's not a global icon. Yeah. He's not on Michael Jackson's
Why?
Bro, I don't think people are passing out. If it's a video now, out there nobody's in the world.
But that's what I'm saying. Nobody's doing that no more because you can see Drake every day.
Nigga, you just said somebody passed out looking at Lil Baby.
But I'm saying it's not really hype like that no more. If niggas ain't see Michael Jackson every day.
People are crying.
Social media is taking your status down a little bit. You know what I'm saying?
Nick, but ain't people crying and passing out at Beyonce's concerts?
Yeah,
too?
I was just going to say.
That proves my point. Beyonce up there too.
I don't know, Kat.
I'm just saying.
Yeah, maybe get Nick on here talking this shit about Beyonce.
I'm just saying, Drake, he's just not there yet. He's not there yet.
He up there.
He's getting there. He's definitely on his way.
You see Drake, you'll pass out.
No, I've seen Drake before. I seen him twice.
You see Chris Brown, you'll pass out.
I'm not going to pass out because I need to have that moment. Like, now, you wait a minute. Now, when you walk me to that car, I might be passed out.
Yeah, I'm going to knock your ass over the head while you pass out. We can get on down, baby.
But, oh, baby, if I see C. Breezy.
So, let's get into these questions. How can you love someone if you don't love yourself? So, this was on Twitter. They was talking about men and women not being able to... how can you give your all to somebody if you don't love yourself or if you don't love who you are as a person yet? The way that they were saying it was that, you know, all these people jumping in relationships, but they don't know who they are first or know what they're, you know, they don't know who they are as a person. Define you. So what do y'all think about that?
I think that's very true. I was just having a talk with a few of my students because one of them is going through like a little heartbreak. And I was letting her know, I tell my kids all the time, I prefer for them not to date in high school. I prefer for you, like, well, not to have, like, a serious relationship. I prefer for you to have friends, meet people, because you don't know who you are as a person. And then I think sometimes we put the value of our love or our happiness on our significant other. And that's not their responsibility. Does that make sense?
Mm-hmm.
So... you have to find out who you are as a person, and you can't do that if you're tied down to somebody, in my opinion. Because when you're young and you're starting off, you're so, well, I want to do this, but I really don't want to leave this person behind. Because you still have to grow. Mm-hmm. You have to elevate, and not everybody has the capacity to grow together.
And they're not going to grow together.
You know what I mean? There may be certain, like, for example, I've always been a dreamer. Like, I've never... wanted to work like a 9-to-5. Mm-hmm. That was not my thing. We started our family at a very young age. DeAndre thing was, I gotta provide.
Yeah.
I want him to provide, but I also want him to, like, you need to, like, do your shit, like, be, like,
move
dream.
At the toot of your own horn.
Yeah. He's like, I need to make money.
Mm-hmm.
So as we are growing as individuals, I feel like I was focused on my dream and he was just focused on making money. And yeah. So we weren't on the same page. So what was important to me wasn't important to him. And I think as individuals, that's things that you have to figure out, and then you can come back together and be like, you know.
That's important. Like, I think for me and Tamika, when we figured the shit out, it was in while she was in college. So like when she was in college, she would tell me all these things like she was going to do this and that. But me, I was thinking, fuck it, I'm just trying to make money. That's all. And I mean, as a man, that's all we probably think about. But a woman is going to dream bigger and try to put that stuff in the play sooner than a man will.
Yeah.
Shit, we were 30, 33, 34 now, and we just now starting to figure this shit out. And put,
I'm not as old as you.
My bad.
Don't put me up there with you.
We just now trying to figure this shit out. And we actually, you know, we kind of getting understanding it, but the women were already a couple steps ahead. Not to say that's a bad thing.
Right.
But it's just, hey, it's just you have to learn to be in love with yourself first. Yeah. Figure out who you are, man. Like, You can't make somebody else happy if you don't love yourself.
Yeah, and you gotta. And I be telling them all the time, like, I honestly don't get offended. I honestly don't feel like I fell in love with, like, looking back, I probably didn't fall in love with DeAndre until, like, 2012, 2013. Yeah. Like, you don't even know what makes you tick. Like, you don't know what you don't like. You don't know what you do like. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like, you don't know your limits, your boundaries, your do's and your don'ts when you're freaking 17, 18 years old.
That's what goes into it. You don't know yourself yet.
Yeah, so I feel like you can't love somebody if you don't even know who you are as a person and don't love yourself first.
So, I think you can still love somebody, though.
I feel like love and having love is two different things.
Yeah.
What's having love?
Having love is just meaning, like, I care about you, I got your back, I'm going to be there for you. Loving somebody is loving them to a fault, like flaws and all.
That's same shit, man.
It's not.
That's same shit.
Is that the same thing?
You can, I see what you said, though, bro.
But I think you can, if you, like, sometimes.
So if me and you ended today, you would still love me if you moved on like 15 years later, got married and had other kids.
It depends on how we fell out.
Yeah, it do.
You cheat on me, nigga, fuck you.
You'll have love for me because of our history.
But yeah, it's depends on how
we... You're still always going to have love for her, but you ain't going to be love with her at the moment.
Nope.
If we, let's just say...
It depends on how we fell out.
Okay, so let's say we just ended like, this ain't working out, like...
If we came to understand it, the love gonna be there.
Yeah.
If we had a...
But you're not gonna love me. You're gonna have love for me.
And that's the difference, bro.
If something was to happen to you, if say you pass away, I loved you. Now I'm gonna be at your funeral, tears. Now, nigga, you fuck me over, nigga. I'll be at your funeral laughing.
Yeah. I'm gonna slap this nigga.
That's being dead serious. It depends on how we fell out.
You
can't.
You might not even love me right now.
Hey.
Nigga, stupid, bro. Shut up, nigga. Shut your ass up. Hey. Shut your ass up, nigga.
You might not even love me right now. Hey. If that's all it takes.
I mean, if you don't know that by now, then hey, baby.
Boy, you better.
But I'm just saying, I think you can't. Sometimes you need. Like, sometimes you might need somebody else to help you understand yourself. Like, you need somebody to tell you your wrongs and shit, or tell you, not your wrongs, you need somebody to, like, kind of
guide you.
Kind of guide you. Because you know some shit you just don't know. You don't know you're supposed to love yourself as a fucking high schooler.
Yeah.
At 19, you're not thinking, I need to love myself, or I need to make myself
happy.
What if you never make yourself happy? Now you done missed out on the biggest thing ever happened to you, shawty.
But that is the point, though,
that's
too.
That's the point. How you going to make me happy if you're not happy?
But that, how do I know if I'm happy or not?
Nigga, because it's a feeling. It's an emotion.
You don't know that feeling.
If you're mad all the time?
It's not about being mad. It's not about being mad. It's just, nigga, sometimes niggas just living in the moment.
And that's your problem, because you always being trying to live in the moment.
That's me. I didn't know about loving myself till I got older in life.
That's what I was just going to say. I think it's different for males and men and women.
I just think it's the person.
Nah, I think it's about men and women, bro.
Maybe.
Men, like you said, we living in the moment. Fuck it. It happened. It don't.
Because you can love somebody more than you love yourself.
And that's the downfall for some people.
So, you know what I'm saying? Like, you can't. So, you know, I'm sitting up here, you keep telling yourself, let me make myself happy. Now you're missing out on life.
But you're not, because...
What if you never make yourself happy? Now you just go die miserable?
Look at
all the shit you passed up on.
It's people like that, but
genuinely not happy as an individual or where you are at in life, it's your responsibility to look at that, reevaluate, like own your shit.
That's you thinking as an older person. When you're 19, you don't understand that. You don't know what's going on.
Okay, so
let's take
the age out of it, because I probably threw the age in there because I was talking about high school students. But as an individual person, no matter how, say an adult.
Okay.
It's your responsibility to know and understand where you are in life, whether you're happy or not. Whether you're happy or not, you cannot possibly love somebody and make somebody else happy or add to someone else's happiness.
If you're not happy. I think you can, man. You know, sometimes you got shit, you battling yourself in your head that motherfuckers don't know about.
And the only thing that make you happy is making somebody else happy.
Okay, being around that person. You know what I'm saying?
I can see that. Even though that's not the correct. It's not a right or wrong thing, but it's just whatever makes you feel good at the moment, or whatever makes you feel good.
Just because you down at the something. What if you never get happy in life?
Yeah, you never accomplish your goals.
Then you're gonna be miserable. But I think that's another.
But what
thing.
If what if somebody bring you joy? You just stop. You can't deal with them because you're not happy.
Well, you're just gonna have joy in that moment. When you go to sleep, you're still gonna be unhappy.
You know, dude, I'm at this moment right
I'm
here.
I'm just speaking for personal experience.
We on the high. Shit, we on the high, baby. You know what I'm saying? Hey, look here, don't pass up on life because you got some shit going on in your head.
It's
well, we're not saying that. We're just saying you need
to. Yes, that's some shit.
Love
in your
yourself
head.
As
you
well.
Need, yeah.
So that's what I'm saying. What if you never love yourself?
At some point in time, you have to love yourself.
That's so far fetched.
I mean, it's people that do. Why do you think suicide shit comes from?
Yeah. Okay. looking at it from that point, yeah, because they're not happy with themselves.
They're not happy with themselves.
And shit and what that if they you, did or
you
whatever.
You fucking live, you just can't get shit. So shit just, sometimes shit just don't go right, bro.
Yeah.
It takes years of shit not going right, and you like.
So to this statement, you're saying that you can love someone if you don't love yourself.
Yes. Yes, you can. I believe you can.
That's different.
I believe you can.
I don't know. It's as a man.
I know you can.
As a man, you probably can.
I'm not saying like that. Don't leave our relationship. We talking right now.
I'm just saying. How you know?
Leave our
shit. You see how quick she go to that?
I was trying to see. He said he know for a fact. I was trying to see.
I just know.
This is good conversation. I was trying to see. Have you loved someone that didn't love yourself?
But as a man, though, like that's the thing. I feel like a man is going to try to love as hard as he possibly can, putting himself fucking last or second on the list compared to a woman. It's going to be a natural thing, I think.
And then again, look on the flip side. Sometimes you can love yourself too much.
And not give a fuck about nobody
else. And I don't
give
a fuck about you. Yeah, then you want to go there.
Sometimes, that's you.
Yeah, I know.
That's you.
I know. That's what I'm saying. Sometimes you can love yourself too much and not give a fuck.
And that's scary,
but,
though. And
then, but on the flip side of that, I can take that because I love myself. I don't need validation.
Okay. That's what I'm saying. But I'm just saying some people.
But it is some women out there that need that. They need that validation.
And some men need to.
And need it too. Yeah. That's true.
So, you know, sometimes shit can go the other way.
Yeah.
A nigga be on some selfish shit around the motherfucker.
When I seen that shit on Twitter, I started thinking. I was like, God damn, that's a deep. That's a deep question,
bro. That's a good one right there. But I think you can love someone if you don't love yourself. I think you can.
And what did you say?
I say no. I just think.
What'd you say, Nick? You say no?
Thank
also,
you,
it's,
Nick.
It's the rule.
It's the selfish person.
Hey, man, I know who I am. I think you can.
Where we going? Fuguee's pop up reunion. I want to get to that earlier. So I've seen on Twitter that the Fuguee's made them wait 3 hours till they came.
It was on TikTok. This lady,
3 hours, bro.
She was like, I didn't even pay, but I want my refund for my water and some other stuff she bought because she said that they only performed like 6 songs. They didn't come out till like 3 hours later. Like that, it was just. Horrible.
I wonder if I can on that track list, on that show list thing, it was only like 7 songs on there, bro. Even though that album was short, if I'm not mistaken. That Fuguee's album, The Score, was a very short album. But I'm not waiting no 3 hours.
Okay. She's like, I have to be at work.
For nobody.
Yeah,
straight up.
That's too long. Like
come on now. And then if you the Fuguee, you supposed to, like, you ain't been seen in a long time.
A long time. You need to be early.
Yeah, you need to be on y'all shit.
But you know what's crazy? I hate to bring this up, but Lauryn Hill got a bad rap for that.
And that's what people was leaving in that lady's comments on TikTok. Like, girl, I don't even know why you went on time. It was Lauryn Hill.
But don't get me wrong. It might be a bomb-ass tour because that Fuguee's album was fucking good as hell.
Like but you not say, if you baby, wait for 3 hours.
I ain't got 3 hours to wait. We left a concert because the nigga was taking too long. And it was
for real?
We left Chris Brown concert.
Oh, yeah.
We in Vegas.
Oh, yeah. I remember that.
He had a residency?
It was a residency.
I was like, I'm ready
to
go.
No shit.
We left. Nigga was taking too long to come out. We got the fuck on down. And the club was live.
It was. But I was
no
just
shit.
Like,
yeah, we left that motherfucker.
And he did.
I know for sure. That's her favorite artist.
Yeah, I was ready to go. We waited a long time.
I don't understand the logic behind artists doing that shit, though. Is it because they waiting for the check or they waiting for the room to fill up?
Ain't no telling what's going on.
It was full. Because he was supposed to go on like at 10 or 11. And when I watched it the next day, I remember that. When I watched it the next day, he didn't go on to like 4 or 5. Like
in the morning?
Yes.
Oh, hell no, bro.
We left that bitch.
Oh, no.
And then it's Vegas, so you already kind of like.
Your time is fucked up.
Yeah, something like that.
Ain't no telling what be going. Nigga probably ain't even there. Nigga probably still flying in and shit.
And see, that's what be. That be my thing. Like, don't have us. Don't put on a ticket fucking 7 o'clock because you know some niggas is going to be prompt 7
yes.
o'clock ready to jam out. And you don't pull up in this bitch till 10 or 11, bro.
I'm ready to go home now.
Yeah. Nigga, I'm tired.
We got tired of buying drinks. He was like, fuck.
You going to be drunk before
niggas.
The. He drunk for the concert. Well,
that's what we were doing.
Nigga, we were drunk.
Let's go ahead and head out.
This nigga taking too long, man. These drinks kicking in.
See, that shit like that is stupid, bro.
These drinks kicking in, man.
But see, that's bullshit because it don't matter to the artist performing because they already got their money for them fucking tickets being sold. It matter to us because shit, it's like we spent our money on this shit.
Yeah, so nah, I ain't waiting no 3 hours. You can kiss my ass.
Yeah. And then on top of that, they not even telling you where they at until the day of the concert. So they just popping up in certain cities and just saying, we're going to be here tonight.
But they know where they can do that shit at. You can't come to Texas and do that shit.
No.
Yeah, ain't nobody going to be there regardless.
They doing all that shit in New York, Jersey.
Yeah, so you know.
The tri-state area.
Nigga, you can't do that. So, I mean, they know what they doing. They know what they doing. Because you can't pull that shit off everywhere.
Yeah, I don't know. I just, I don't want to talk about that shit. Yeah, I don't want us to be depressed about the, that shit. Yeah.
What, the Border Patrol?
Yeah.
Shit, we can talk about it.
You want to go into it right now?
Because we ain't got to stay on it long, but I seen Trey pull up down there and wasn't nobody there.
They gone. They moved them all now.
Yeah.
So what the fuck they at?
I don't know, but I saw that on the news when I was going to work on Friday.
They moved them all.
So now,
and they moved them all within an instant.
Yeah.
Which is
crazy, because y'all could have.
So all these people been out here this whole time, y'all out here whipping them and shit, and all of a sudden, bam, they gone overnight.
And what's crazy is that they were saying that they planted photographers down there. Professional photographers down there for them to take pictures for us to see that shit.
Yeah,
because also you can see on what news I be watching, Fox. You can see the photographers like they got like a full on. Some of them didn't even just have a camera; like they had like a full on.
These niggas standing in the water and shit, getting snaps.
Getting
when I seen that picture, bro, I said that picture too damn good. That's a good ass picture.
Good ass picture. So that's what they shit.
It's just
I mean,
like a show almost.
I'm following Trey Page right now because they was down there. So I'm like, what the fuck happened?
They didn't brought the bulldozers out and
they got everything down there and there's nobody there.
Cleaned it out.
It looks like nothing ever happened.
Nothing ever happened. Looked like a freaking ghost town.
Not one person. He said they can't find one person. I've been following Trey for the past couple of days. There's nobody there. He like, what the fuck is going on down here?
And I meant to watch. Kamala Harris was just on one of those. I think it was The View. I meant to go back and watch it, but to see what she had to say.
Yeah, before she came out, they escorted two of them. Because they had tested positive before she even came out. They escorted them off.
Yeah, so I just wanted to, I mean, that Border Patrol. I don't know what the fuck going on down there with them people.
I don't know either.
They, like whipping them though. That is crazy.
The horses and they try to make it seem like they moving them out the way.
While I was listening to one podcast and they was like, did they really hit them?
Are they just doing that to take a picture?
I mean, but that's bad publicity for them, so I don't know about that one. Because now they're on the investigation.
Mm-hmm.
So that one kind of didn't make sense to me. But when they said that, I'm like,
what else would you have it for, though?
Like, what the fuck are y'all trying? Like,
what's the angle?
I'm on my T-Rob shit. Like, what's the angle? What's going on? Like, it's something deeper than that. So,
like we said last week, though, we don't even know how the fuck they got there.
Still don't.
On the podcast I was listening to, they were saying they started migrating when they got hit with that hurricane early in the year. So they've been left Haiti. They just been traveling.
In packs,
trying to get away wherever they can go. And I guess, so it's obviously a lot more people out there somewhere.
Mm-hmm.
Shit is going on somewhere else. The same shit that's at the border. So. But they saying they started leaving when they got hit with that hurricane. Like Haiti fucked up right now.
Fuck, dude. Back to why do old people wear tighty whities? So I was looking at this. I seen it brought me up to Plies. So a long time ago, Plies had posted a video saying he was shopping for some drawers and he thinking he got the boxer briefs. And he said he ended up buying the Tighty Whities.
Them were the panty ones, right?
Yeah, yeah, with the ass cheeks out. So I started thinking, I was like, damn.
Stave used to wear.
That's all my grandpa used to wear was the Tighty Whities.
I think that's some old shit. That's like, that was all it was. That's why them niggas is used to that.
But
I remember when I was in elementary, my mama said, I remember her saying, you don't need to wear drawers, I mean boxers, because it make your nuts hang. The tighty whities keep your nuts up.
Yeah.
So that's what my mama told me. So that's, even then, I was like, I ain't wearing no fucking tighty whities. Still give me the goddamn boxers. So, but she was like, I remember her saying, like, tighty whities keep your nuts up. And boxers make your nuts hang.
Yeah.
And, you know, boxers, they when they came out, that was like the shit to wear. I don't remember. I think it was like, I don't remember. But I know tighty whities, that was like the only thing they had back in the day. That's what the niggas used to.
I wonder how long boxer briefs been out.
Boxer briefs didn't come out to, I remember, like my 11th or 12th grade year. So like 05, 06.
So, wait, so you had high school niggas back in the gap walking around in tighty whities?
No, in high school, niggas walking around with big ass boxers on.
Oh, okay, okay.
Boxer briefs is a tight shit now.
Okay, they was just regular boxers on.
They was just boxers.
And you can't even find those no more, really.
Nah, you can. Yeah. They out there. That's
boxers?
That's what I wear.
Yeah.
For real?
Boxers in Walmart. Because Stave don't like the tights.
The briefs.
He likes the briefs, but he don't like the tight ones.
Oh, okay.
You can get some tight ones.
Like the compression one.
The compression. I like the compression.
I like the compression.
That's so when I seen this, I'm like, now I see what old niggas think. I don't like no loose shit on my ass.
I need it packed in.
Yeah. So it makes sense. So now I'm on my old man shit. I gotta have my tight. I ain't gonna say tighty white.
But you would rather wear the compressions.
I'd rather my shit be.
You'd rather have your nuts up.
In place.
I'd rather have them things up, baby.
In place. Yeah, bro.
So
like,
I know now that I'm older, see, in high school, I was like, I needed to lose boxes.
Need to let shit breathe.
You need to let that shit breathe. Funky ass. So now that I'm older, I need this shit tight, baby. I don't want, like, nothing wrong. It's nothing worse than getting up and your ass is all like shit. Like, nigga, and we got on some boxes or something. That shit ain't cool, man.
Bro, when I seen that shit, I said, oh, come on, grandpa. And he was putting us on game early. He used to tell us, yeah, y'all walking around here with these old loose ass drawers. When you get my age, you're gonna want some shit to keep your nuts in place.
Keep your nuts up, baby. And that's like even like the drawers I wear now. Like my drawers are like fucking short. They come way down here.
Yeah.
I don't like them. I don't like the rise.
Yeah.
So if I look at that pack,
once it start rising, it start rising, I'm throwing
motherfuckers away, baby. I don't like the rise. I need my shit. So I like what are they, like tights?
Nigga, you wear biker shorts.
Yeah, well, I like biker shorts still, shit. As long as them motherfuckers tight and keep them things up.
Yeah.
So that's what I like. I guess back in the day, they didn't have color.
So yeah, they all the color white and black.
All they had was white.
Because my grandpa had a goddamn drawer full of white.
I only think they had black. I just think it was all, I've never seen.
Black didn't come later on, probably.
Yeah.
Till Michael Jordan got with them Hanes.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, so that's what I think it is. I just think niggas ain't like that loose ass fit. And then I think that's all it was back in the day. I don't remember growing up seeing niggas in drawers with my daddy in drawers and shit. I mean in boxers.
Just tighty whities.
Yeah, all that was tighty whities.
Yeah.
Stave wore tighty whities. Well, he had cars tighty whities, but he wore tighty.
Don't put my son business out like that, man. Damn, man, that nigga loved them drawers.
Yeah, we all would have loved them drawers. Shit, them were the best drawers.
I was a boxers nigga.
Nigga, I was wearing them motherfucking Ninja Turtle ones, nigga.
I wear them boxers, baby.
Wore them Ninja Turtles.
Loose ass 4X boxes on, nigga. Fuck, I'm doing these big ass draws.
That's why your crack was out.
Come on now.
Do you like strip clubs and do you tip?
I love them. I love the strip clubs, but I'm not the tipper.
That's how I am.
I'm the nigga. I love to go watch. I love to watch.
I love to watch.
I can't. I'm not the nigga that fuck it up. You're not going to see Z and that bitch wild and throwing the money, right? I'm telling you, you're not.
Ain't going to get that bando.
I get a 100, 200 maybe, if I'm feeling good. And then I'm the nigga in the corner just
holding on to my shit.
Peeping the scene. I like to see the niggas fuck it up in the club. I like to see niggas going crazy in that bitch because I'm the nigga like, not. Yeah, because I'm not.
Yeah.
I'm sorry, man. My money come the slow way. I work for this, so I'm not in that bitch just throwing it the fast way. So I love to go,
but
I like the strip club.
I love the strip club.
I'm not gonna. I hate paying.
Last time we went to the strip club,
She was holding on tight.
She got a little carried away.
Oh,
I'm a good tipper.
I said, hey.
I said, hey.
What the fuck are you doing?
He said,
nigga, slow it down. Slow it down.
But you didn't like her because she was aggressive.
I don't like aggressive strip. That's why I don't want to be in the limelight. I want to be in the
back. Yeah.
Leave my broke ass alone. Yeah. I watch you from a distance. Yeah. I don't need to touch you, nothing. I don't need to be the nigga like, oh, let's go to him. And when we walk in strip clubs, that's what they flock to.
Mm-hmm.
They flock to me. I ain't too long home, but come on now, baby. They flock to your boy. And I don't like that shit.
Because they know you're going to spend that money, nigga.
He's a horrible tipper.
In a strip club.
In the strip club.
And
yeah, food and shit, that's different.
Anything
that's
else,
different.
I'm a great
tipper. He's a horrible tipper in a strip club.
But in a strip club, I'm not. And I will give you a couple of dollars. But it's, I give you $5, $10. All right. Yeah. I'm good.
I'm good. He was like, I'm good. I said, oh, my God, sir. It's so embarrassing.
Yeah, she throwing like, she not even looking. She just
making it rain in that bitch.
I said, hey, what the fuck are you doing? You need to motherfucking chill the fuck out.
Just having a good time.
Make it rain.
A good time could go in fucking 2 minutes in the strip club.
Yeah, you be in and out that bitch.
Like, we need some more ones. Like, what the fuck you mean we need some more ones?
It's time to go.
Yeah, nah. I love going to the strip club, but I.
Oh, another thing people go to the strip club for is the food.
Oh, did we eat? No, we ate at Blue Flame, I think, right?
Yeah, that's the only strip club we ate at.
The chicken wings.
The food, they said the food be good.
I mean, it was good, but I ain't trying to be eating no food with no ass out.
I am.
I ain't trying to look at no food.
Multitask.
Bouncing on my chicken wing.
Yeah, I ain't into that. Now your ass all sticky. And shit. Your ass on, man. I never understood that one, though. Now I get something on the way. I know I'm finna leave the motherfucker. Let me go make a run. That's what I did. But I ain't going in there to eat. Get that steak and fries from Obama Tuesday.
Get that lunch special.
Let's see what we got next. Are men more jealous than women? I say they are.
Are men more jealous than women?
So we had this conversation a couple episodes ago. What is it? Insecure, jealous, right?
Mm-hmm.
And as y'all listened to that episode, we both, as a matter of fact, it was just me and Z on that episode, and we said that we were some jealous motherfuckers.
Yeah.
But, you know, jealousy comes with a price. So we do have a lady on with us today. So, like we said, we are jealous. But what do you think?
I think it depends on the person. But I also think that men are more jealous than women, if that makes sense. For me, I'm not the jealous type. I'm not jealous. I will give the benefit of the doubt first, but I'm also, I could read people.
Mm-hmm.
So my jealousy is going to come in if I see if I know this chick and I know she be on your stuff, or I'm like, I've seen some fishy things, then my jealousy is going to kick in. But if we're just out and about, like, and you speak to somebody, I'm not going to be like, who the fuck is that?
Who the fuck is that?
Nah, fuck that.
So I think it just depends on the person.
Yeah.
Until that episode aired, I didn't even realize. I forgot all about that situation he had talked about. I didn't even realize. Because I was like, why would you say that you were jealous? Like, you're not. And then when I listened to the episode, I'm like, oh, I completely forgot about that. And then when me and my sister was talking about it, it happened on two occasions.
But
when
you,
we was in the club, when you was
talking
like that you
her
cousin. Oh, your cousin. Oh,
yeah.
I forgot that had like even happened. I'm like, dude, you're not jealous. And then when I listened, I was like, oh, you
forgot
shit
about that shit.
Yeah.
I flip all this shit.
I think all of us had that jealous moment where you're like, man, who the fuck is that?
But I don't think it's men more jealous than women. Like, I think it's just the people. Like, I ain't gonna say men.
It depends on the person.
I think everybody jealous.
I would say men, because men won't give a woman the benefit of the doubt. Like, even when you're working with men, I feel like automatically think that if you're working with a man, if his wife or a significant other or whatever is working with a man, that in his mind, that man probably wants to like mess with her, talk for to her or something.
Yep.
Like, I don't feel like women, I don't think that's our first instinct until we get a vibe. Does that make sense?
Okay.
Like, if a female is being overly friendly, we're like, okay, we got to watch her. But we're not going to automatically think like, oh, she want my man. Mm. Like, a man is going to automatically think, oh, that nigga touched on your lower back. That nigga, man, he was helping me. Like, what's the problem?
What the fuck he helping you up for?
Yeah.
I mean, yeah. A gentleman.
You don't see me right here, nigga? Get the fuck on.
Helping her down the stairs and shit
like
that.
Come
what,
on.
You got, what you trying to do that for? What you trying to do that for, dog? I know our niggas think.
And that's what I'm talking about.
I know
about.
Our niggas think. Married niggas, single
doubt.
Niggas.
No benefit of the doubt.
Hell nah. Fuck. I know niggas at them all them work wives and shit. That's my work wife, all that good shit, nigga.
Yeah.
All right, nigga. I'm right, nigga. Yeah, you can play with me if you want to, Jack. I'ma come for everybody, motherfucker.
Yeah.
But nah, I think women do the same thing. So I ain't gonna say men is more jealous than women. I just think everybody jealous.
And I think it kind of depends on who, what they jealous of.
And maybe jealous, is a strong word.
Yeah.
Maybe it's like insecure.
But you know what? You don't realize how strong of a word that is until you were in a conversation about that shit.
I'm
listening to it now. I'm like, damn, jealous is a strong ass word.
That's why I said maybe jealous ain't the word for it.
What's
maybe
another word? Not insecure.
Not insecure?
Nah, because that's
those are two different things.
Yeah.
Well, fuck it. It's jealous of what it is then. Jealous of what it is then. Because, man, hey, I just know niggas. I know niggas. And I'm not speaking like black men. I'm speaking of men,
period. In general.
I know men trying to fuck something.
And see, that's his thought process with everything. Like, anybody. Like, he does not... I could be like, oh, no, they're friends. No, they fuck. Like,
they
what?
Fuck
they're literally friends. Like, everybody that has a male friend and a female friend don't mean that they fucking.
Yeah.
Or we could see, no, this happened a couple of weeks ago. We saw somebody in a parking lot. He was like, oh, they cheating. What are you talking about?
Shit. Like, Benny, it never fails. We can be somewhere.
Like,
if we somewhere.
They could
sitting,
be on a first date. Like, why do you automatically think?
You don't go park your car nowhere else and just jump in and jump out real quick. Y'all both go y'all separate ways. Y'all been doing something. Y'all been fucking doing something. You don't go meet up at a place.
He just never give people the benefit of
you damn time. Right I don't. You never go to a place and then motherfucker, when have I ever picked you up and we came back and that's a bad example.
We just did that. We do that all the time when we don't want to drive. Exactly. Exactly. We do that like every other Thursday.
But you follow me out. We don't go separate ways.
Yeah.
It's because we're going in the same direction, but we're going to go to the house. You're going to go to the school.
Nah, motherfucker, that's different. That shit different. But I see these motherfuckers out, man.
You don't know what they got the it's same thing going on we got going on.
Okay, we don't get out the car and kiss and shit and hug.
Oh, no, we about to see each other.
Exactly.
So they could be dating.
Yeah, still courting her.
Yeah.
They don't want to see each other families, this and that shit.
Yeah.
I believe that shit y'all want to.
Come on, baby.
Y'all believe that shit y'all want to, man. Them niggas fucking. They done came, they done fucking went and had a quickie real quick and came back and went their separate way.
Now, I was just curious because it's just, you know.
So what do you think, men or more?
I was going to say women.
Really? Oh, my God.
I say women.
Why?
I say women, too.
Because.
Motherfuckers try to play crazy.
Because. Women have this instinct that the same way we feel about every man wanting a this and that with y'all, women have a different instinct than a man. Y'all feel that every woman that y'all don't know or that y'all think y'all know wants us.
I think we read, we can read another female and be like, oh, no, this whole friend. This is too much.
She a motherfucking psychic and shit. Like she thinks she read the card and shit. Yeah, I ain't no goddamn card. You can't read me, baby.
This is too much.
You can't read me.
That's too much. She doing too much. But then you can't.
But okay, so let me ask you this. What is doing too much from a female, from a woman standpoint?
Like, for me, it'll be like if she's constantly like touching him.
Okay. That's a red flag on both ends from a man and
a
woman.
So if she was like, "Oh, it's nice to meet you. Okay, cool. I'm gonna let that one slide."
Yeah.
You know, because
Yeah.
But then if she was like, oh my God.
And then that so nice little rub, you? Then like, no, I like it on my back.
You know, your wife was telling, like, things like that.
Reach a little low, reach a little low.
Okay, yeah. Now, you know, she needs to chill. That's too much.
Yeah. Now, I think that goes both ways, though. The touching, that's a red flag from a man and a woman standpoint. But it's just a woman have a different, it's just a different instinct that maybe they see shit that we don't see. Mm-hmm. Because like they say, men are dumb. Hey,
men
are dumb.
See, y'all look at that touching shit. I look at the shit the motherfucker ain't doing.
Because remember, we went to that restaurant. And we went to this restaurant, right? DeAndre was all dressed up. So when we go out on our dates, like how we were dressed the night, that's how we dress, right? So we went, then one of his friends told him to come.
Don't say one of my little friends.
No, I was going to say high school football player, but I don't even know if he went to high school with us. But one of his football teammates invited us to this restaurant where he works at. And so we went.
Oh, okay.
And it was a lady that was like kind of, how the tables were, it was like kind of catty corner,
mm-hmm.
and she kept looking at him. And so at first, I'm used to it because people think he is really somebody. Like, I don't know why.
Yeah, he tells us that all the time.
And then if
famous.
Somebody approaches him, then he gets to lying, saying that he's this person that he's not. So at first, I'm thinking like, oh, they think this nigga is somebody, right?
Or maybe they listen to the pod. They're looking at the videos.
But then she's like, she gets up and she like sashays and then she flips her hair. And I'm like, oh, this bitch.
You looking at details like
yes.
that.
Yes. And then like when she sat down, she kind of moved her chair and like crossed her leg. And I'm like, DeAndre, this lady is like doing the most. And so he was like, you know, she just wanna. And I'm like, no, pay attention. Even when we left, she kept looking at him.
But see, that's what I'm saying. That's the instinct that you have that I'm like, we don't see that. Oh, we're not paying attention to
like,
it.
So she flipping her hair so she can see if you're watching her like walk
but
off.
But see, she caught it from the get go.
But she got mad at me because you don't see that bitch over there. I'm like, come on, what you
see?
Doing? I'm like, look at where we at, baby. I got you on the rooftop. We having this nice dinner.
No, do you see it or you fake trying not to see? Like, you don't see this bitch being extra. Like, come on now. Cut it out.
Say? I'm a big deal.
We waiting for the car from valet and she like.
That's when I called and I said, wait till she see the car we pull up in.
And that little cheek. I was like, DeAndre, you don't see this lady. So stuff like that, that's what I mean. Like, I'm not going to care at first. But then if I like am catching shit, like come on now.
Yeah, but you see, that's why I said men are dumb. We need to see physical evidence of a woman cheating as far as signs. Y'all catch the signs way ahead of time. And y'all already, it's like an instinct. Y'all acting jealous already.
Yeah.
And it's not a bad thing, but it's just the instinct that a woman has.
Nah, I say man happen too. I watch the signs. You can catch the signs. Nigga girl, nigga ain't too friendly or it's just a little, you know what I'm saying, that type of shit. You can catch signs,
man.
Well,
on the last podcast, you said we can't talk for 2 minutes. Now, what you want? You want long conversation or short conversation?
You keep shit short. Well, I'm around. You keep the motherfucker short.
60 seconds.
Yeah, not even 60. Nigga, hey, how you doing? Okay, keep moving. Don't give a fucking don't double blink, motherfucker. I'm watching blinks, nigga. Don't double blink and be like, you give a little motherfucker that. Yeah, all right.
Oh shit.
Alright.
Don't blink twice.
Don't blink twice, motherfucker.
So this brings us to the next question. What does it mean? Well, this kind of go back to what we're talking about, jealous, all this shit, really. You know, what does it mean to be insecure? So Insecure. we all watch the show Insecure. Shout out to Issa Rae.
I know,
you know,
so sad coming to an end.
Yeah,
I never watched it.
Oh, you need to.
He couldn't get into it.
It'll open you up. It'll open your eyes to a whole nother.
He watched the first season and he was done.
It'll open your eyes to a whole bunch of shit, bro.
If you want to binge watch it, we can, because that's my shit.
Nah, you know, because I don't like. Okay, go ahead.
No, it's just, you know, what does it mean to be insecure? Why do men feel insecure and why do women feel insecure? From a man's standpoint, what do you think? Because it is a whole bunch of insecure men in this world.
I think it's just like, I don't know. Like
me? Okay, so for me, my insecurity started in elementary. Like, nigga, I knew... Nigga, my ears was big, lips was big.
Oh, you mean like, just, I thought you was talking about like in a relationship.
No, just insecure, period, as a person. You know, like I knew I wasn't the hottest nigga in the streets, but once you start feeling yourself and you start feeling out, yeah, I'm a high commodity, nigga. So I think men, but it goes for men and women, and I'm not trying to speak for a woman, but I think, you know, women is the same thing. They have to feel good about themselves in order to go to the next level with a certain thing, yeah. Basically. Like me, I know I felt insecure at a young age.
I felt insecure at a young age too.
But you grow
like,
in.
Is that feeling insecure, or is that just like, is that just not loving yourself?
Well, I don't think I loved myself when I was younger. I don't think so. Because I didn't look.
Is that being insecure though?
Well, you can have insecurities about how you look.
Yeah. And I guess that was my thing.
When you think about insecure, you're thinking about insecurity like being in a relationship. But you can have insecurity.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking at first.
As yourself, like he mentioned his looks. Like I used to be insecure about my weight. Why you laugh?
Cause I got a little inside joke about that, but. Man,
nigga stupid.
There's insecurities like about a lot of things, not just like about being in a relationship. Like for one, when I was younger, I went to school in the South Side, so I was like the only black person in my class. So I was insecure because I didn't look like nobody around me. Then I was fat with fucking Medicaid bifocals blue. So, you know, and then as I started getting older, my body started to develop. Mm-hmm. So then I really didn't look like nobody like me. I was like, fucking had tits in the sixth grade. And then, like, because I didn't look like nobody like me, I picked out things like how my top lip is brown and my bottom lip is pink. Like, things like
that. You started
that.
Looking at other shit.
Yeah.
That's crazy. I never kind of really thought like that.
But once I, like, got old, I think, like, when I got to, like, the eighth grade, mm-hmm. I started like, you know, like I started feeling myself.
Yeah, you found your own way.
I started slimming down. Like I just, you know.
And that's one thing, like anybody out there, high school, whatever, like you ain't the only one that.
I was insecure about this goddamn dot that I got on my nose. That was a chicken pot. Like
for
I got
real?
My goal was like, when I turn 60, I'm going to get my nose pierced so I can hide it. And I really tried to. And the man was like, ma'am, we cannot pierce your nose right there. Like, but damn. And then I had a student do a facial on me. She was like, where is this dot from? And I was like, oh, I had chicken pox when I was little and I scratched it and scarred. But yeah, I used to be insecure about that little thing. I don't even know which side it's on.
That's crazy. I never really thought about this. But like, I guess not like being insecure, but you just felt, you just kind of knew your flaws.
Yeah.
See, my thing was I always kind of accepted it. Like, you say something, like, my thing was you just can't say shit to me. Like, so if somebody, like, I had a chipped tooth. So if somebody said something about a chipped tooth, nigga, I'm going to try to chip your tooth.
Yeah.
So yeah. That's kind of, I never felt like insecure about it. It's just like, nigga, say something about my chip tooth, nigga, I'm going to give you one.
So yeah. As an adult, do you have insecurities? Like, as an adult, right now, do you have insecurities? I'm insecure about my body.
See, like, I don't, I can't do the, but like, I like being big.
Well, I'm not saying that has to be one of your insecurities. I'm not trying to
sit up and act like I'm this perfect man. Like I don't want to come off that way. But I really don't think about shit like this. I really don't, bro. Like I like feeling insecure. Like
about
as an adult, I don't feel insecure about nothing now because it's like I didn't find my own wave.
That's what I'm saying. Like
I
can't say like I feel insecure about something like. Maybe I just don't. Maybe I don't know. Maybe I gotta put. I gotta.
But it is still people out there that feel insecure.
Yeah, yeah.
So,
definitely.
Like, we not telling y'all like to, you know, go harm yourself or do stuff to yourself to, you know, make you feel. But just know that once you get older, you will find where you fit in at. Basically.
See, because like, okay, what is something you're insecure about? What is something like you said you don't know? So, what is something you're insecure about right now?
My stomach. And
so the way I think is go do something about it.
Well, I am. I've been working out.
She not the only female that.
But
I mean,
I'm trying to put y'all like how I think.
Yeah.
Like, so you insecure about your stomach? Have you been working out?
I have not recently.
You have
not recently, but I had. I started.
And you went down.
Yeah, I did. Okay.
So but that's what I'm saying.
It's
like
a whole bunch of women out there that but that's
I'm trying to say the way I think. Like, if you feel like, if you feel fucked up about something that's going on with you, fix it. I ain't got time for this moping and shit.
But
bro,
some things you can't fix.
That's why I said I don't want to sound like I'm just,
yeah, like cosmetic type shit. Like, you can't.
Oh, what? Like, what? Like, really? What? Give me an example of something.
Like, somebody might have, I'm gonna hate to say it, but somebody might have a bigger nose than what they think.
Go do something about it.
How you gonna get rid of a bigger nose?
Look what Michael Jackson did.
His dick.
No, like, let's be, I'm not trying to be funny right now, and I'm not trying to be, like, this perfect thing. Like,
so you have never been and are not insecure about anything as an individual?
I'm not going to say nothing have ever made me down about myself. I had a chipped tooth, got it fixed.
Okay, here's a better example. I used to be, because let's just take, like, physicality out of it. DeAndre has always been the breadwinner. Right. So there was a point in time where I felt insecure because I felt like I wasn't pulling my weight.
Your weight.
Does that make sense? Yeah. I wasn't pulling my weight financially.
Yeah.
So there was once upon a time that I felt insecure about in that sense. Does that give you a better? No.
I mean, it did. But what? So, okay, so did you mope about it or what did you do?
I mean, I didn't. I mean, you're still the breadwinner. I just accepted it. And I try to do like other little
things
to make me feel like I'm
so
not
me and her are basically almost the same, because now that you said the adult thing, before me and Tamika got together and before she graduated college, I think that's what my thing insecurity was. I was trying to figure out ways to make money quick and fast, this and that, because I already seen where she was going. Mm-hmm. So my thing was try to cut it off and meet her halfway. Mm-hmm. And I was always a step behind, but now I feel like now I'm coming to the point where, no, I'm not, and I say I'm not making as much as her, but once we finish the program, it'll be damn near even. So I felt like in due time, it did come. Mm-hmm.
So was you insecure about that, or are you just saying to yourself, I got to get my shit together?
I was insecure about it. Okay. It was at times, bro, and I hate to put this out there, but it was at times that I literally felt like I shouldn't have been with her, because I felt like I had to, back to this, I had to learn how to learn myself first on what I can do as a man to try to be on her level. I was trying to compete with her, and shit was just, it was just bringing clashes.
And that's how I felt. I felt like I was a burden, because I'm constantly having to ask, like, hey, can you pay my half for this? Or hey, can I have gas? Or hey, can I do, like, he has his own. Well, we're 50. We're 50-50 in our household. Well, kind of.
Yeah.
So in my head, I'm like, he is my plan B, but at the same time, I shouldn't constantly be asking for his help. Because see, then I feel like I'm putting him more in a hole, because he's not going to tell me no.
And see, that
and
was,
I should be,
that's crazy.
And it's crazy that if I feel like if he needed help, he wouldn't tell me, because he know I can't help him.
And see, that was my thing.
Like, what is really my role if I can't? If he can't come to me,
yeah,
because I can go to him and say, hey, I need this amount of money, or I need this, I need that. And he'll, even if he really can't give it to me, he'll still give it to me. But if the roles were reversed, where the fuck I'm going to get it from?
So
I'm getting it from him.
That's crazy, because my thing was,
I don't even think like this.
That was crazy, because my thing was, if I'm in a hole, no matter what, I'm not asking Tamika for shit, because I'm as a man, I'm bringing my 50 to the table. I would go ask my pops or my grandma them before I asked her, and she would get mad about that. But now I've grown, I've gotten to that place and matured enough to be like, okay, this is 50-50. With me having to cut back on work because of this program, I tell her like all the time, you know, we splitting it 50-50. I'm backing you up, you backing me up. But I, to this day, I still won't ask her to do more than what her 50 is. And as a man, that kind of hurt a little bit.
Yeah.
You know, that make a nigga feel, you know, like, I need to step your game up.
Yeah.
But it's just like, it's just, it's insecure as a motherfucker.
Because it got to the point to where I'll start going to take out fucking payday loans, and he'll be like, don't you have this bank, nigga? That bank is
gone.
I done ran that debit card out. Like, overdraft collected, baby.
Yeah.
I mean, I don't know, man.
Yeah. It's men out there like that, though. That insecure shit, bro. And, but, I mean,
See, my I don't want to call it insecurity though. I just want to, maybe it is insecure. I just look at it a different way.
Yeah.
Now I look at it, if I'm fucked up or I need some money or something, I'm gonna go get it.
Yeah.
And then I know if people are like, how you gonna get the money and all that type of shit. Figure it out.
Yeah.
And that's always how I've been. Since a kid, like, I haven't asked my daddy for money in over 20-something years.
Yeah.
My daddy haven't gave me a motherfucking dime.
Yeah.
Probably 25 years. Coming up, I asked my mom for something. She'd be like, figure it out.
Mm-hmm.
I ain't got no money for that. Figure it out. And that's how I've been my whole life. Like, and I don't want to say money. I've been that way about everything.
Everything.
From you name it, I've been that way. Yeah. I will figure it out. And it's not, I don't know, bro. I don't know.
So, since you relate, like, insecurities to relationship, why do men feel insecure in relationships? Because you have to answer an insecure question.
Then that just, the way their wife make them feel. Or the way they significant other make them feel. If I come home every day, you fucking around. See, okay. If I come home every day, you be like, damn, you fat ass slouch, like.
It'll make you feel
yeah. But then me, I'd be like, bitch, who the fuck you talking to?
Yeah.
So you know that'd be the difference in the shit that'll happen versus another man compared to me.
But if your significant other is putting you down, that'll make you feel insecure. Yes.
It probably would make men feel make me feel insecure. Cause I ain't gonna tolerate that shit.
We got it.
That's how I think.
Yeah.
Like, you're not finna come in here and be putting me down every day and I'll just be moping around. Bitch, fuck you.
Yeah.
You're not finna be, I'm not, I mean, but then again, like, if I have a problem, I don't know, bro. That insecure shit crazy.
That's good conversation, though.
I guess that goes into loving yourself.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I love me, man.
We know.
Nigga stupid.
I don't want to, because it sounds like I'm this perfect guy. That's how I sound in my head. Like, you think you this perfect guy, but I really don't. I really just don't let shit like that get to me. I really don't. Like, that shit, I don't know, man. That's crazy. And just hearing how y'all think, like, I think nothing like that. I don't even think that way.
You know how you said the other day, because you didn't pick up no load. What was it, Friday? Or was it you only had one load?
Yeah.
And you was like, man, I've been here all day. Like, man, I just fucking feel like a bum. Like, help. That's like a form of insecurity.
Nah, that was like me. I need to get on my shit. What did I do? What did I do?
Mm. He gets on my nerves.
That's what I be saying.
How do you have a podcast with this cat?
But that's how I think. Like, damn, man, like, shit ain't going right. Nigga, make it happen.
Yeah.
Made it happen.
You definitely did. That you did. But I'm just saying, that's like an example.
But that's not an insecurity. That's just me feeling like, that's, I don't want to say it's an
example.
I don't know, man. Nigga, figure it out. Man, I ain't got time to be moping and shit, bro. I don't got time
but
for that shit.
Insecurity is not meaning you're moping. It's just a feeling.
I'm talking about me. I'm not talking about, like, y'all call it insecure. I call it moping. If it's shit going on with me and I feel like I'm moping around, or if I'm fucked up about something, I make it happen.
Okay. Why do women feel insecure? That could be a lot of things. That could be how they look, how they significant other make them feel, I guess.
Yeah, that's a deep conversation. Deep. So anybody out there, y'all listening, just ask your significant other, you know.
So why do women feel insecure? Give me your take.
I mean, I don't feel comfortable speaking for all women, so I'll speak for me.
Yeah, speak on you. That's what I do on this motherfucker. I speak about me.
I would feel insecure. It will be basically self, because I'm secure in my relationship. My significant other makes me feel like, you know, I'm the baddest, even though I know I'm not.
Oh, you working at it. You wearing that orange today, baby.
Shut up. I have my own insecurities that's like self. But I feel like to a certain point, like if a woman is constantly being cheated on, that is going to make her feel insecure. You know what I mean? Or even if she's not being cheated on and maybe, you know, they just don't have sex on a regular basis. His her significant other doesn't make her feel wanted, like, that can make her feel insecure. But I feel like I'm secure in who I am. I know I'm not, you know, the baddest thing walking, but it's only one me.
Yeah.
Like, it could be, the bitch can have the baddest body, the whatever. She can be on her shit, got her own everything, but she's not me at the end of the day. So I'm secure in who I am.
Who you are.
Yeah. So, I mean, it just depends, because it can go both ways. It could be self. It could be a relationship. You could bring insecurities from another relationship. You could have the best husband or boyfriend now, but your previous relationship, maybe
fucked you up.
Yeah.
Fucked you up.
I mean, it just depends. Even now, even though one of my insecurities is my body, I dress like the fuck I want. insecurities and all. And I've had people bring that up. And DeAndre, we like, well, I'm not. And I talked to him about it. And he was like, well, I'm not an insecure. I've even had my dad. I just added my dad on Facebook and I posted a picture. And I remember him saying, he must be a hell of a man to not care what you wear. And I'm like, what? He was like, yeah, you posted a picture and your boobs was all out. And I'm like, what? And then it was like, after he made that comment, multiple people over time would like speak about how I dress. So finally I asked DeAndre, like, does it like really bother you? And you just never say anything? Because when I go on vacation, he actually helps me pick out my stuff.
Yeah.
Like, I'll be like, is this cute or is this? Now, he may say like, oh, your chest out, but he doesn't say it to where like I can't wear it. And I would still wear it anyways. But like, that can be, when my dad said that, I'm like, in my head, I'm like, well, you're just insecure as a man. Mm-hmm. Because what I have on don't mean shit. It's an outfit.
Yeah.
Like, if I want to cheat or whatever, I'm going to do it. I could do that in a pair of sweats.
Yeah.
Like, talk your shit.
That's how it should be, though. I mean, like, that's a, you can go a whole bunch of different routes with that word, see, insecure.
That, like, how her daddy told her that. I'm not even thinking like that in my head.
Yeah.
I'm like, God damn, girl. That shit on,
yeah,
baby.
Yeah.
That's how I'm thinking. Like, yeah. God damn.
And my thing is, how I dress when I'm with my friends, I dress the same way that I'm when I'm with him.
Mm-hmm.
So I always say, like, if there was to be a problem, it should be a problem then if I wasn't wearing the same thing, like, when I go on a girl's trip. And then I get with my dude, and then I want to be all covered up.
Yeah.
But I've even had, when we talked about the strip club, I even had friends be like, you go to the strip club? And I'm like, yeah, like, they, and their thing is, this is probably gonna be weird, but me and my dad talked about the strip club because him and his wife wanted to go. And I'm like, you should go. And he was like, I don't know, like, it won't bother you. And I'm like, bother me about what? He was like, well, if he fantasizes about, he could fantasize about the bitch at HEB. Like, what is people's what thought? And I was like, to stop? Me, that's a form of insecurity. Like, why are you worried that about, he could fantasize about the bitch that just gave us a McFlurry. Yep. Like, to me, that's like a sign of insecurity. So I think a lot of that just has to do with like yourself and maybe how your significant other makes you feel.
Mm-hmm.
I don't
know. So you can go a lot of different ways with that insecure word, bro. That's why I keep on telling you need to watch that show, bro.
I might check it out. But then again, I don't need to be, I don't want to dig into it.
No, it's like, it's a funny It's like, it's really, that show is really good because it's real life. Like, if you ain't never dealt with nothing that's in that show, you know somebody that has.
Mm-hmm.
It's like real, it's really, really good. It's really good. We're going to try to binge watch it. Well, I'm going to start you on season 2 because you really wasn't feeling season 1. Season 1 was a little slow.
Yeah, see, I watched season 2 first and then went back to season 1.
Yeah, so I'm going to start him at season 2.
And then that's when I kept up after that.
Because season 1, I think after season 1, probably like the first 3 episodes, he was like, Janay, I'm not watching that shit.
Yeah, I started with season 2.
Bro, like,
I'm going to start him with season 2 where the juice is at.
Yeah, that's where I started season 2.
And then again, I probably like, we go see it and I'll talk about it next week then. Yeah, I'm gonna tell you what I like and what I don't like about this shit.
Birdman on the Big Facts podcast. Did you see? I know you probably seen the highlights.
No, I watched it.
You did?
I watched it.
What you think?
Well, I listened to it. I like the way he's popping the shit on them.
I do too.
I just watched. But like
how Big Bank was telling him, that's probably why people think of you like this, because the way you pop your shit.
Mm-hmm.
But I don't think nothing wrong with it.
No,
I don't think nothing wrong with it.
I like the fact, though, that he cleared that he put the bullshit to bed about him not paying Nicki, Drake, and Wayne. I like how he put that shit to bed finally.
Mm-hmm. I'm not even about that. Cause everybody know them niggas was getting money. But I'm talking about the people before him, like Manny Fresh. I didn't know the shit about Manny Fresh.
He paid them.
I didn't know he paid the nigga the money. I didn't know why. I knew he paid Juvenile because Juvenile went back. He's, I don't know what's going on with Turk, but he say, nigga, I was 19 with all this money. I didn't know what the fuck royalty and shit was.
Publishing. That's what he said. He kept on saying publishing. Like,
but I made it right.
He, that publishing is a big fucking deal, bro. Like, I keep on telling, I was telling me and my homeboy had a debate at work about him, and he was like, he felt like he knew what it was. I was like, but bro, you gotta understand, those, that paperwork, that's a different type of language for a 19-year-old, bro.
I can't read that shit now, and I'm 30-something.
That's a different type of language, bro.
So, I mean, I like the way he's popping this shit on that. Like, nigga, everybody got something to say. Y'all niggas just talk. Y'all know, I know what the fuck I'm doing over here. And like you say, Lil Wayne asked for 30, and he gave him 50.
Gave him 50.
Damn. So Lil Wayne ain't saying nothing. Why y'all niggas on my dick? Why y'all niggas saying shit? And like he talked about the situation with the Breakfast Club. He like he that wasn't supposed to go like that.
No, he said he was up there to do a
interview. But he wanted to also tell them.
Yeah.
What tell Charlamagne. Yeah. About like, nigga, stop playing with me.
Yeah.
Like now I understand where you come from. Like your daughter comes and like, why does this dude keep talking about you? Mm-hmm. You not even paying attention. Like, then you finally start listening, like, nigga, what the fuck?
Yeah.
Like, if my daughter tell me you saw a nigga saying something, like, and I know it ain't true, hey, nigga, stop fucking playing with me.
Because he, and from the sound of it, it sounded like he was going to give them the exclusive.
How he talking with them, he like, this how, y'all the voice for down here.
He was going to talk to Breakfast Club about like that.
But he just wanted to get that off his chest.
Yeah. But shit went to a different level.
He said it wasn't supposed to go like that. It just... That's just how it was. He like he said he kind of regretted.
Yeah.
But he like, well, fuck it. It is what it is.
Yeah. Yeah. But yeah, shout out to Birdman.
That was a good interview, though.
He also said he popped the shit on there about he's created more artists than Puff, Jay-Z, and Jermaine Dupri. Oh,
dang. And them facts.
I believe it. He said he's created more artists that make more money than them.
But that's what I said on a podcast a long time ago. Y'all killed me for that. I said Birdman, but I only named Lil Wayne. That was a millionaire or some shit. Jay-Z.
Jay-Z.
When I said who made more millionaires.
We said, and at that time, we said Hov, just because of Kanye. Kanye and Rihanna, basically.
And I said Birdman. Y'all killed me for that. And the Birdman got on here popping this shit.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. He
come
did.
On now.
He did pop his shit.
The dude on here popping his shit. Like, ain't none of them niggas did what I did.
And he none said that. Them. And he said that shit. But he also said that, referring back to NBA Youngboy, he said NBA Youngboy gonna be the biggest artist, but Drake is gonna make the most money ever.
Oh, wow.
He kept saying NBA Youngboy. He liked that nigga.
Yeah.
He like NBA
and
Youngboy.
Now that I finally started listening to his music, I said I was going to start going back. Now, I don't condone nothing that NBA Youngboy does. I want to put that out there.
Man, that man living his life, bro.
He living his life at a young age, and I say he ain't got no the proper guidance, maybe.
He don't.
And that's all it is. And we're not saying that he don't want guidance, but he needs some type of guidance.
He probably does, but at 19 with that much money, what you gonna tell a nigga like
he's
that?
He's young.
Nigga, I don't need you.
Yeah.
The fuck you telling me? Yeah. I'm paying you, nigga.
Yeah.
The fuck?
You so can't what you come gonna on? Tell what you gonna tell a nigga like that?
Yeah.
And he really out there. He will shoot your stupid ass. You come playing.
Yeah.
So it's kind of hard to.
Maybe his timeout will help.
That's normally what happens.
That's what they thinking too.
That's what I was hoping with Kodak.
Yeah.
But now I see Kodak is starting to. He's starting to get his shit. I love Kodak. I fuck with Kodak hard. But he just does ignorant shit. But nah, Birdman, like, and then I think he right about Young Boy.
Yeah.
I think he right about him.
Nigga, he already, I wish I can pull up. I would have had the numbers pulled up. But I believe he already almost had 1 billion streams. And he ain't even been out that damn long.
And he don't promote.
No.
No promotion.
No promotion.
At all.
Kids love him, bro. My daughter love that nigga.
This generation love him anyway,
bro. Them kids love Young Boy. I like him too, man. I'm
starting to get into him.
I fuck with him.
Before we get up out of here, Raising Kanan finale. Y'all seen it? You seen it?
I watched it this morning.
I watched it this morning too.
I watched it this morning.
Fucking Raquel, bro. She's like a Tommy mixed with Ghost, bro.
She, yeah.
Who's Raquel?
The mama.
Kanan mama. She's like a Tommy mixed with Ghost. She's ruthless, but she thinks like Ghost. And I don't want to be comparing the two shows or comparing the two characters, but she thinks of every possible situation that can go wrong.
And it does.
And it does. But she's thinking past that shit for backups or whatever. Did you like the last one?
Yeah, I liked it. I just hate I gotta wait long to see
for this, another one
for some more. I don't know, bro. At first I was like, cause you know, like I say, now that I know Ghost and Tommy ain't coming,
yeah.
So now I can really watch this shit. So now I can watch it for what it is.
Yeah.
And now I like it, bro. Like, this shit is live.
When they coming?
They ain't coming.
They not
at all.
Yeah.
We're not gonna see them. Courtney said that we'll never see them.
And I still think she lying. I still got a little hope they come. They gotta come.
They dead in there now, so people will stop asking.
I'm about to say they probably tired of everybody everyone's anticipation.
Because yeah. The first three episodes, I'm like, where my dogs at?
But you know, and looking back at the old episodes, so I looked at the old episodes of Power when Kanan first got out and he first seen Ghost for the first time since he got out. And he was like, shit, y'all practically raised me. No, Ghost and Tommy told Kanan, like, y'all, you practically raised us. Like, you was like our daddy.
Exactly.
So if we do see it, it might be maybe season 3-4, when Kanan get older.
But see, my thing was, I thought, then this is what made me think I ain't gonna see it, because I thought they went to school together.
Mm-mm.
No, I thought they just said they came up together.
They came up, like, Kanan raised them. He taught them the game.
That's what I took.
But for how long? Like a year or two?
They making it seem like it was long, because on those episodes I was looking at, Jukebox said, you let Ghost ass, the one that was walking around with a fucking book in his hands all the time, outsmart your ass. Jukebox told him, he said, the little motherfucker got smart on my ass. But that's all right. I'm going to get his ass back.
I still hope they... Now, Courtney needs to stop that bullshit. She can go and bring my dogs in, man. I want to see Kanan and go. Just a little glimpse of, you know what I'm saying? Just so I can get it off my chest. So I can stop looking for that every episode.
Yeah.
Is Tommy going to ever really have a show?
Yeah, he's come out the beginning of next year.
They done filming already.
Tariq come on November.
Yeah.
Season 2.
So.
She ain't into that gangster shit.
You ain't been watching it,
Nah, she's too busy watching Insecure and shit.
What happened was, one time we didn't have Showtime and I didn't like how it looked on the stick or whatever it comes on.
Yeah, that should have turned you off if it don't look good too.
Whenever that happened, I just never got back into Power, because I was like, it looked like a bootleg. Because he wants to watch it like that day, because he said people gonna get on Facebook.
You gotta watch it that day.
And you know
the shit out of it.
And you know, on the stick. Back then, it would be like the next 2 days that you'll have the good one. And so I just was like, I'm not watching that shit no more. So I just asked him what's going on to get my update. But did you watch the season finale of Non Perfect Stranger?
Yes.
Did you like it?
Yes.
That shit was good.
Marsha. Marsha is.
So what?
Nicole Kidman. First off, Nicole Kidman has been coming with fire lately, bro.
I've been liking everything she's in lately.
Like The Undoing. She was killing in that shit, and this, bro, I was not expecting that to end like that.
And I'm like, how she just gonna make man boy and his girl took his goddamn car.
She took the Lamborghini.
But I can't wait. If there is a season 2, I can't wait.
I don't think they'll do it. I don't think they'll do it. I just don't see any possible.
Because of how it ended.
How it ended.
Like, everybody was on their own.
Yeah.
Hey, we started the Wu-Tang.
You did?
Man.
Yeah, we got to finish it.
I told you, bro.
Say. And, you know, the only thing now since I'm getting into it, now they're getting their names, I didn't know who the fuck was who at first.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? I'm not no Wu-Tang fan.
Yeah.
I don't know none of them. I know their music. I don't know them.
Yeah, you don't know them by faces or, personally or whatever.
Yeah. So, but now we into it, and we're on season 2 now, dog. This shit is live.
I told you.
This shit is live.
Is Lala in?
Wu-Tang?
Is she in the movie? I mean, the show?
I don't know.
Oh, okay.
I don't know.
Yeah, she's been waiting on Lala to come. She ain't came. So
I don't think she on the...
I don't know why I thought she was.
But what episode you on? You just started season 2?
Season 2, like episode 2 or 3.
Oh, okay. So
We finished when they were at...
They on the boat.
Raza was
on the boat.
Like,
finna get off
in
the... They on the ferry. They on the little ferry.
It's paused.
You finna get you finna get to the good shit.
Now it's getting to the good
it's
shit.
It's finna be in, intense like a motherfucker.
Well,
like,
so now, he getting the Wu-Tang, he getting the group together.
Just those, because those are the ones that had the big problems and shit like that.
Yeah. And I was telling him, I was like, man, so I was telling DeAndre, I was like, man, watching shows like that make me wish, like, I had what, like, I could think, like, let me just for real do
some shit.
Yes, because I said, no, this fool didn't been to jail. He didn't have a whole, like, he will not give up. Like, that shit
got
is
got fucked
crazy.
Out of a contract with, like, Eric B. and them, Rakim.
Then lost his tapes, had to shoot the man to get the tape. Like, you didn't have to move to
that's
a whole
passion.
Other, like, I, like, oh my God.
That's like your vision. You see what you want
to
do.
But I told her, it's easy to do that. That nigga ain't got no bills or nothing. So I told her, snap out of that shit quick. That nigga ain't got no bills.
I said, this nigga.
And he ain't got no kids, which is a big thing.
That's what
too.
I told her. She's like, man, I wish I could just do it. I'm like, that nigga ain't got no bills.
I said,
that
this nigga.
He going from city to city, yeah. House to house.
Yeah.
So unless you want to do some shit like that, and go ahead. But right now, lady.
we got bills to pay.
You can go live out your dream, but nigga, you go work too.
But yeah, that shit finna get good, man. That next the episode that just came out on Wednesday, They met the man. Killed that episode.
And see, I didn't know he was around that long.
Mm-hmm.
I didn't know, like, from the very beginning. So, I mean, yeah, I'm into it now.
But when you hear the contract talk on how he was trying, like, how he was doing it, and his brother, it was shit that came out, like, years later about his brother being sneaky and changing wording on contracts and shit. So, on this last episode that came out Wednesday, when you see it, you'll understand what I'm saying.
That's
like,
probably why he was into all them contracts in the first episode.
Yeah.
When he was working for that construction company, because he was like, "What do people even read all these codes?"
And see, his brother is the business holding the contracts and shit. His brother's
a
sneaky motherfucker.
Whoever ain't watching that Wu-Tang series, I got tired of hearing Benny talk about it. But nah, man, that's some good shit. That shit good.
Hot takes. Ozark trailer finally dropped, baby. We finally got a date. Everybody that be waiting, 2022.
What? Are you fucking serious?
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
You watch Ozark, Nick? Oh, man.
Oh, you got to get on it. It's good.
I told Tamika, we're going to have to binge watch. We're going to have to start back watching a season a month until fucking...
It starts out really boring, but I had absolutely nothing else to watch on Netflix, and so I watched it, but it's good.
Ozark is the shit. But it seemed like, you know... I can't remember on season 3 it ended with them in Mexico when they
killed that lady. Right?
Okay, so the preview basically just shows them in a bathroom scrubbing
like the brain,
blood and shit off their hair and shit like that. But they in Mexico though this time, at least from the beginning anyway.
Yeah.
Also, Stranger Things season 4.
That's Aaliyah shit.
They announced that same thing 2022. Kanye doc. On Netflix, supposedly coming in 2022.
God.
J. Cole song. I know you heard this, Nay.
I did. I listened to it twice. I liked it.
I liked it. I like how he did it over Pipe Down.
Yeah.
The Drake joint Pipe Down.
And Drake just gave... I didn't watch the little video that's been going around, but Drake supposedly gave him his flowers at his concert or something. But I didn't watch it. But yes, I listened to it on Friday.
And I'm being on the record to say, him and Tyler, the Creator, their album is better than Drake album.
Come on now, Vinny.
Hey, I'm putting it out there, bro.
I don't listen to Tyler, the Creator, but I will definitely say I did like, because I like J. Cole's album after the first go through. I didn't have to like play it back. But you know, I'm a big J. Cole fan.
Yeah, you know, I ain't.
and shout out to them UTSA Roadrunners out
there.
They
doing their thing.
4-0, baby.
Them niggas doing their thing, fool.
4-0. They came back last night on Memphis ass.
I've never jumped bandwagons. You know, I'm a UT Longhorn fan. But I'm finna start rolling with UTSA, dog. UTSA, they got the city looking good, fool.
They looking real good.
You know, a lot of those players, some of those players are from here.
Yeah.
Yeah. So they, you know.
But what's crazy is that in order for them to get them here, they have to do super bribing from what I heard.
I mean, rightfully so.
Yeah. Got to get you to stay home. Or
every
whatever.
Nigga trying to make it, man. Nigga ain't got time to be a guinea pig. Nigga, you trying to make it. So, you know, but the way they starting and, you know, niggas is going to the league now for UTSA. So, now, come on, bring that big city shit down here.
So, on that note, Nay, we want to thank you for being on with us.
in a time.
Very, very special. Y'all make sure to also shop with her.
Please, JLux.net.
Let's get on up out of here to some smooth grooves. Adios.
To the next one, I be running back. Go your way, I go my way, but somehow we be still attached. Trying to find my answers with this cup, but ain't no truth in it. They be like, I'm done for fucking with you. I spent stupid racks. I'm sitting here knowing.